Hello everyone, this is Dr. Deepa. Today we learn about the axillary artery. As we all very well know, axillary artery is the artery of the axilla in the upper limb. So we studied the axillary artery under the following headings, that is, extent, the parts and the divisions, the relations of the axillary artery, the branches of the axillary artery and the clinical aspects of the axillary artery. To begin with, the extent of the axillary artery. This axillary artery is the continuation of the third part of the subclavian artery in the axilla. So, the axillary artery enters the axilla as the continuation of the third part of the subclavian artery. It extends from the outer border of the first rib to, this is the first rib, the extension of the axillary artery is from the outer border of the first rib, descends down to reach the teres major muscle and ends at the lower border of the teres major muscle. So I repeat, the extent of the axillary artery is from the outer border of the first rib to the lower border of the teres major muscle. Beyond this lower border of the teres major muscle, the same axillary artery continues as the brachial artery in the arm. Regarding the parts or the division of the axillary artery, the entire axillary artery in the axilla is divided into three parts. The artery is divided into three parts by the muscle called as the pectoralis minor muscle. Now, this pectoralis minor muscle divides the entire axillary artery into three parts. The first part of the artery is proximal to the muscle, the second part of the artery is deep to the muscle, and the third part of the axillary artery is distal to the muscle. So, this is how the axillary artery is divided into three parts. So, the first part of the axillary artery extends from the outer border of the first rib to the upper border of the pectoralis minor muscle. The second part of the artery is hidden beneath the muscle itself. The third part of the axillary artery extends from the lower border of this pectoralis minor muscle to the lower border of the teres major muscle. So, this is about the parts or divisions of the axillary artery. Moving on to the relations of the axillary artery. Now, as we already know that there are three parts of the axillary artery. Now, each part of the axillary artery have specific relations. Overall, the entire axillary artery is related to the cords and the branches of the brachial plexus. It is related mainly to the cords and the branches of the brachial plexus. This axillary artery is always in relation with the vein, that is the axillary vein. So remember, the axillary vein is always located inferomedial to the axillary artery throughout its course. So, inferomedial to the axillary artery lies the axillary vein. We look for the relations of the axillary artery step by step. Firstly, moving on to the relations of the first part of the axillary artery. So, the relations are anterior relations, posterior relations, medial relations and the lateral relations. So, anterior or relations in front of the axillary artery in the first part. So, the first part of the axillary artery is related anteriorly to the muscle pectoralis major. Then, there is a small loop of communication between the medial and the lateral pectoral nerve. So, the loop of communication between the medial and the lateral pectoral nerve, the pectoralis major Beneath the pectoralis major, there is a fascia which is called as the clavipectoral fascia. So all these make up the immediate anterior relations of the first part of the axillary artery. So the posterior relations of the axillary artery are the muscle, which is the serratus anterior. So it is mainly the first and the second digitation of the serratus anterior which makes up the posterior relation of the axillary artery, and the nerve supplying this muscle, that is the long thoracic nerve. So these are the immediate posterior relations of the first part of the axillary artery. Now the lateral relations of the axillary artery are the lateral pectoral nerve, the lateral cord, and the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. So the first part of the axillary artery is mainly related laterally to the two cords of the brachial plexus, that is lateral and the posterior cord of the axillary artery. So the among the three cords of the brachial plexus, the lateral cord and the posterior cord of the brachial plexus is related laterally to the first part of the axillary artery, whereas the medial cord of the brachial plexus is posteriorly related to the first part of the axillary artery. The medial relation is the axillary vein. Yes, medially the first part is related to the axillary vein. So I repeat, the relations of the first part of the axillary artery will make it very simple. So first part of the axillary artery is related in front, that is anteriorly it is related to the pectoralis major muscle. Beneath the pectoralis major muscle there is a clavipectoral fascia. It is related to the loop of communication between the medial and the lateral pectoral nerve. Posteriorly it is related to the serratus anterior muscle, mainly the first digitation of the serratus anterior muscle and supplying nerve supplying the same muscle, that is the long thoracic nerve. Medially the nerve artery is related to the axillary vein. Laterally the artery is related to the lateral and the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. So I repeat, the relations of the cords of the brachial plexus with that of the first part of the axillary artery. The medial cord is posteriorly related to the first part of the axillary artery, whereas the lateral and the posterior cord is related laterally to the first part of the axillary artery. So these are the relations of the first part of the axillary artery. Now next, moving on to the relations of the second part of the axillary artery. This second part of the axillary artery is very important because the relations of the second part of the axillary artery is directly related to the cords of the brachial plexus. That is, lateral cord is lateral to the axillary artery, medial cord is medial to the axillary artery, whereas posterior cord lies posterior to the axillary artery. Very simple. So anterior relations of the second part of the axillary artery is the pectoralis major and the pectoralis minor muscle. Posteriorly the second part is related to the muscle, that is subscapularis and the posterior cord. Medially the artery is related to the medial cord, and of course there is an axillary vein. And laterally the second part of the axillary artery is related to the lateral cord of the brachial plexus. So the cords of the brachial plexus are named in its relation to the second part of the axillary artery. So now what is left out is the relations of the third part of the axillary artery. Always remember, the third part of the axillary artery is related to the branches of the cords of the brachial plexus. So this third part of the axillary artery mainly come in relation to the branches of the cords of the brachial plexus. So there is anterior relation, posterior relation, medial and the lateral relation. So anteriorly the third part of the axillary artery is related to the medial root of the median nerve. Posteriorly The artery is related to the muscle, that is subscapularis, teres major. Along with this, the two branches of the posterior cord, that is the axillary nerve and the radial nerve. Medially, the posterior, the third part of the axillary artery is related to the axillary vein, of course. In between the axillary vein and the third part lies the two nerves, that is medial cutaneous nerve of forearm and the ulnar nerve. Yes, the medial cutaneous nerve of forearm and the ulnar nerve lies in between the third part of the axillary artery and the axillary vein. The medial most is the location of the medial cutaneous nerve of the arm. So these are the relations of the third part of the axillary artery. So I repeat, the relations of the third part of the axillary artery are: anteriorly, the third part is related to the medial root of median nerve. Posteriorly, the third part is related to two nerves, two muscles. The two muscles are subscapularis, teres major. The two nerves are axillary nerve and the radial nerve. Medially, it is related to the axillary vein. In between the vein and artery lies the ulnar nerve and the medial cutaneous nerve of forearm. Medial most lies the medial cutaneous nerve of arm. The lateral relation of the third part of the axillary artery is mainly the musculocutaneous nerve. Musculocutaneous nerve is related to the third part of the axillary artery in its lateral part. So this is the relation of the entire axillary artery. Now next is the branches of the axillary artery. As we have already discussed, axillary artery has three parts. Yes, there are branches of the first part, second part and the third part. Very easy to remember. The first part of the artery gives one branch, the second part of the artery gives two branch, and the third part of the axillary artery gives three branches. So in total, there are six branches of the axillary artery. One branch from the first part, two branches from the second part, and the three branches from the third part. So what are these branches? The first part of the axillary artery gives a small branch, which is called a superior thoracic artery. Yes, the first part of the axillary artery gives only one branch, that is superior thoracic artery, which runs along the pectoralis minor muscle and ends by anastomosing with the internal thoracic and the intercostal arteries. So this is about the small branch arising from the first part of the axillary artery, that is superior thoracic artery. So that is superior thoracic artery. So this superior thoracic is from the first part. Now moving on to the branches from the second part of the axillary artery. This second part of the axillary artery gives two branches. Number one is the thoracoacromial artery. Number second is the lateral thoracic artery. So these are the two branches of the second part, that is the thoracoacromial and the lateral thoracic. So this thoracoacromial artery, once it arises from the second part of the axillary artery, immediately pierces the clavi pectoral fascia. Yes, this thoracoacromial artery is seen piercing the clavi pectoral fascia, and once it pierces the clavi pectoral fascia, the artery is seen dividing into its four terminal branches, that is acromial branch, clavicular branch, deltoid branch and the pectoral branch, supplying the adjacent structures. So these are the four terminal branches of the thoracoacromial. The second artery arising from the second part is the lateral thoracic artery, which runs downwards and ends by supplying the lateral thoracic wall. In females, this lateral thoracic artery gains importance This is because this lateral thoracic artery, in case of females, give lateral mammary branches supplying the mammary gland. Moving on to the branches of the third part of the axillary artery. The third part of the axillary artery gives three branches. Yes, it gives three branches. One is anterior circumflex humeral, posterior circumflex humeral, and the subscapular artery. So among these three branches, it is the subscapular artery which is the largest of all. So the subscapular artery is the largest branch of the entire axillary artery. So this subscapular artery arising from the third part of the axillary artery runs downward in front of the subscapularis muscle. Here it gives one important branch which is called as the circumflex scapular artery. Yes, the subscapular artery, as it descends downward, gives one branch which is called as the circumflex scapular artery. As the name itself says, circumflex, this circumflex scapular is seen winding around the lateral border of the scapula to enter the infraspinous fossa, supplying the respective muscle. The anterior and the posterior circumflex humeral, as the name itself says, circumflex humeral refers to the artery winding around the humerus. So the anterior circumflex humeral and posterior circumflex humeral are the arteries which are seen winding around the surgical neck of the humerus and ends by anastomosing to each other, thus supplying the area adjoining the humerus over here. So these are the branches of the axillary artery. So I repeat, in total there are six branches of the axillary artery: one branch from the first part, two branches from the second part, and three branches from the third part. So here is the picture where we can just make out the anastomosis between the anterior circumflex and the posterior circumflex around the surgical neck of the humerus. So anterior circumflex humeral artery, this is posterior circumflex humeral artery, winds around the surgical neck in anastomosis with each other, supplying the area of the upper end of the humerus and the adjoining shoulder joint over there. The posterior circumflex humeral is seen associated with the axillary nerve in the quadrangular space. This is the same picture showing the quadrangular space, whereas the posterior circumflex humeral reaches the surgical neck of the humerus by passing through the quadrangular space of the scapula, and it is seen in association with the axillary nerve. So lastly, about the applied aspect of the axillary artery, the axillary arterial pulsation can be easily felt in the lower part of the lateral wall of the axilla against the humerus. This arterial pulsation can be felt, and sometimes we can also block the arterial pulsation in order to test the level of bleeding in the upper limb in case of amputations or thrombosis or infarction. There is something called as axillary arch. This is a variant arch, a fibrous arch, which is sometimes appreciated extending from the latissimus dorsi to the teres major muscle. If at all the arch is present, the fibrous band is present, in some individuals it may be seen compressing the axillary vessels, leading to the venous thrombosis. So these are some clinical aspects in relation to the axillary artery. So this is as a whole about the axillary artery. To rewind, So we have studied about the extent of the axillary artery, parts of the axillary artery, relations, branches, and the clinical aspects of the axillary artery. Thank you.